Hello there. Welcome to Node Toolchain for Newbies. In this Node.js course aimed at Node.js beginners, I will talk about the best tools and the best practices. And all those practices, they will increase your productivity, they will make your development more joyful, better, easier, and faster. So let's dive into some of those libraries and tools. What tools would you recommend for Node development? This is one of the most popular questions when I teach my workshops. We will cover some integrated development editors in our environments, or code editors, some libraries, some graphic user interface tools, and some command line interface tools as well. So there are four categories of the Node toolchain that every Node developer should be using and should be aware of. Let's start with code editors. Atom is one of the most popular code editors. It's based on HTML, CSS, and JSS, and it's based on Node.js. It uses this tool, it's called Electron, the framework, and it's maintained by GitHub. So it's built by geeks for geeks. It's very customizable because it's all CSS and JavaScript, and it's free. VS Code. VS Code is another editor which is very similar to Atom, and VS Code is my favorite editor right now. I switched from Atom to VS Code. It started as Microsoft Azure's Monaco editor, which they use in the Azure cloud, so you can edit your code in the browser. And basically, it also uses HTML technology, HTML, CSS, and JavaScript, and it also uses Electron. So it's also very customizable. So what I like about VS Code is that it has intelligent autocomplete. So it uses TypeScript, which is support for classes in JavaScript, and it can basically look up that definition of a particular library and give you all the definitions there, and it will give you the signature of a particular method or a property. So it's very, very convenient, and just the speed of innovation, how fast they introduce new features and make it even better and better, it's amazing. It's super, super great. And one last thing I like about VS Code, when you just download, and if you're a complete newbie, if you're a complete beginner to Node.js, it comes with all the installed presets, with all the configured things, with everything pretty much ready, unlike Atom, where you would have to tweak it in order to get the same functionality. So VS Code, highly recommended. It's free. You can click on a link and get it now. WebStorm is another alternative. What WebStorm allows you to do, it's a fully developed IDE, unlike some other code editors which try to get more and more features, but they not have as many features as IDE. The downside is that it's not free. So WebStorm, developed by IntelliJ, it's not free, but it's a professional tool. It's good to make an investment, $60. You can make that in an hour or hour and a half of your development time. So definitely great investment. But I never used it and never actually had a need. Well, of course, you don't know what you don't know, but for me, from my Java development days, IDEs were super complex, overly complex. With Node.js, we don't need to compile anything. So we don't actually need a complex IDE. We need a simple code editor with some highlighting and maybe some type checking. So I cannot recommend WebStorm, but I should tell you about it. So take a look at it. If you are familiar with other IntelliJ products, then that could be your good choice. Other editors. Brackets is also based on web technologies, so similar to Atom or VS Code. Sublime Tech 3, it's been my popular editor, my favorite editor before I switched to Atom, and I still keep the Sublime Text shortcuts. Even in VS Code, you can do that with a short plugin. Sublime Text 3, it's a fast native application, but I haven't seen much of the recent improvements recently with Sublime Text 3. And then Of course, we have Eclipse, Aptana Studio, NetBeans, Komodo IDE, and some of the interesting cloud solutions. So Cloud9 will also allow you to deploy, to commit to Git. Cloud9, it's fully in the browser. So if you have a Chromebook or you have an older laptop, which is getting slow at running Node.js, Cloud9, take a look at that. You have you need to install zero things basically with Cloud9. Okay, so what to pick? I recommend VS Code. VS Code is the way to go in 2018. This is how it looks like. It gives you a beautiful interface. It has a autocomplete, so you can see app.use. That's an express method. It gives you the definition as well, so you can look up what actually, how to actually use it. Then you have the packages, for example, different themes. You have install support for Docker, you have debugging, you have Git support, and the Project Explorer view. So you can debug right in your code editor. You don't need to go anywhere else. It's amazing. You can make commits, and there are tons and tons of other plugins and themes. As you saw, there is one for Docker. There is one for Markdown. I really love it, especially having the Markdown preview. That's how I'm writing my new book right now. So I use VS Code, not just for code, but also for the slides, for the Markdown. And it's great for JavaScript, it's great for Node.js. It's built on Node.js, and it has the first language support for it. So my recommendation, VS Code.